Hello everyone, welcome back to C Programming. Today we are here with a new topic called as unions, which is very similar to structures. You can find a lot of similarities, but there are also some differences. Let's understand why do we use unions even though we have structures, okay? So first let's see the definition of it. The basic definition, as I've told you, it is very similar that it is a collection of data items of different data types, which is similar to that of structure, okay? And you can see the declaration is also very similar. You can see the data type number one, data type number two, like that, of different data types. We just, instead of the difference which you can observe quite clearly and the basic differences in structure, we use the keyword as struct is the keyword, but in unions here we are using the union as the keyword. So we can have n number of data types like this, which we can have in structures also. So those are the similarities. Now let's see the accessing of this. Let's see whether it's similar or not. Yes, there it is also similar. You can see we use a dot operator. For structures also we use a dot operator by member dot function, then we access it. Here in unions also we are using the dot operator, and we use this operator. The symbol which you can see here is the operator for pointer to unions. In unions also we have some pointers. So example is, we have an organization which needs to have different data types. For that, how we use this, we can take union organization char name 25 and char designation 10, so that is nothing but character. And we also need salary, so that is a different data type. Now that you can put up here. And the thing is, union organization employee 1 is equals to this and union. So this could be accessed by variable 1 dot member 1. So that would be the accessing of it. Now we have given for each, like there are 25 names you can give. So in that Ramu, Gopal, like that, I have given two employee names for example purpose. I have given only two employee names, but you can give many as you want, depending upon the size of the thing which you give. So that could be just accessed after you declare the structure. It could be just accessed by a dot operator, which is very simple and easy to understand. So that is about the dot operator and unions. So basically unions are very very similar to that structures. But why do we use union is basically the memory value assigned to one member will not cause the change in other members. But in unions, value assigned to one member may cause the change in value of other members. So when we need to change, when you're assigning one value to one member, if you want to have any change, so that time it could be used for unions, and only one member can be assigned value at a time in unions, whereas in structures all the members. So basically unions are there in use, but they are not that useful as structures. So but we need to understand the basic use, like why I have made this video, because we need to understand like why unions are not used than structures, and what are the advantages of structures over unions. If we understand that, then we could understand the concept of structures more clearly. So that makes it apt and why it is more useful than unions. We usually know that most of us know that unions are not used, structures are used, but we do not know the reason. So I wanted to tell you all the reasons why, and that we will continue later in the differences. So before that, let me go to bitfields ones. So bitfields are nothing but, it is a set of adjacent bits within a single machine word. So they are mainly used to save the memory space or to combine several states of information within a single machine word. When there are several states, instead of wasting memory, we can use bitfields to combine it into a single word. Suppose now you have an integer variable which has one or two values. So the integer variable that time occupies 16 bits of memory to store the variable, whereas only one bit is enough to store the variable value using bitfields. So you're trying to understand, the thing is, we have only one bit, that is 1 or 0. It, instead of using 16 bits, it should use only one bit. So that time when we use bitfield, 15 bits of memory would be saved, right? So as there are no data types of 1 bit, 2 bit, So that time bit fields are used. We do not have, when we have only bits of data to be stored, then that basically creates a lot of problems of memory gets wasted, right? So that time when we use bit fields, that memory which goes waste is saved and it helps us. For example, now we consider the following data to be saved about the student, like male or female, distinction, first, second or third. In order to save gender, we require 1 bit, and to save the grade, we require 2 bits. Thus, we need only total 3 bits are required to save the information. So declaring the structure for student information using bit fields would be a normal structure. We could have struct student and unsigned gender 1 and unsigned gender 2. So the colon indicate that is unsigned gender, you need to put a colon and 1. So the colon which we are using indicates the use of bit fields, and the number following it represents the width of field. So that is the declaration of bit fields. You could just write instead of you know, the data type in structure, right, unsigned and whatever you want, gender or whatever, and just put 2 colons and how much ever bit fields you want, that is. So that's why bit fields will be very useful. Now let's see the differences between structures and union. I hope you'll understood about bit fields. If you'll have any doubts regarding that, please do comment and let me know. So the basic differences between the structures, as I've told you all, the first difference would be the keyword. You all must have noticed that when I've told you all, that is, we use a keyword struct in structure and union in to define a union. And the size is, when a variable is associated with a structure, the compiler allocates the memory to each member. So the size of structure is greater than or equal to the sum of the size of its members. Whereas when a variable is associated with a union, the compiler allocates the memory by considering the size of the largest memory. So basically what happens is, in structures, the size of the structure would be depending upon the sum of all the of each member, the size that is, sum of the size of each member would be the size of the structure. But whereas in union, it is not like that. In union, whichever member has the largest size, that is the largest data type, which is having largest size, would be the size of the union. So that would be the difference of allocation and memory. Each member within a structure is assigned a unique storage area of location, and in union, memory allocated is shared by individual members. So in structures, what happens is, each member you have would be stored in their own unique different locations, whereas in union it doesn't happen like that. Each member would have to sometimes share its locations. Then value altering is that altering the value of a member will not affect the members. As I've told you all, the memory allocation, when you're trying to change the value of one member, will not affect the others in different locations, because when they are in different locations, when you're trying to alter one, it would not affect the one. So that happens in structure. Whereas in union, since they're sharing the address and memory location, the thing is, when you're trying to change the value of one, obviously the other one which is staying in the same thing, it's like when you're staying in a house, the qualities of one person would obviously affect the other person, right, due to the companionship or anything like that. You can understand in unions also, when they're trying to share a memory location, when you're trying to change a value of a particular item in that memory location, then the item in the then the other item in that particular memory location also tries to change. Then accessing member, individual member could be accessed at any time. It could be done at any time. Whereas in union, only one member can be accessed at a time. That is, each member accessing is, independent of each other. It does not depend on each other in structure. Whereas in unions, one member only could, when you're trying to access only a particular member of one thing in a union, suppose when we have gender, name, and everything, when you're trying to access name, you cannot access gender. So that thing happens in union, which is shows that they're not independent of each other. Whereas in structure, each member is independent of each other. Then initialization, several members of structure can initialize at once. Whereas in union, only the first member of a union can be initialized. That is, each member could be initialized in this, but only if the first member could be initialized in union. So when you see the pros and cons and everything, the structures are more useful than unions. So that is why people use more of structures than unions. But unions are also a bit useful. Now I hope you all understood why we use structures more than unions, and I hope you all got the answer to why unions are better and why why structures are better and why not unions. I hope you all understood this video and I hope you all liked it. If you all really like my video, please do rate me according to your wish and just follow the above link to get notifications regarding my videos. And if you all have any doubts, please do comment and let me know. Thank you everyone for watching my video.